On May 29, 2016, a group of guys from Jesuit High School embarked on a journey to Tijuana. Me, Mark, Brandon, Kyle, Randy, Brendan, Tim, Josh, Gary, Max, Father Pierce, and Mr. Barnes all flew down to Mexico on an immersion trip. The goal was to work with a charity organization named Esperanza, and we helped construct houses, learned more about the Mexican culture, and formed relationships through love and service. This is Building a Community. Around 2:15 in the afternoon, we landed in San Diego and headed towards the border.
What just happened, guys?
Guns.
Yeah, lots of guns.
Well, there was some walking, and then there was some talking, and then there was some stamping, and now we're in Mexico.
From there, we met with two Esperanza volunteers who drove us over to the place where we would be staying for the week, La Posada.
Long drive. We just came up here. It's a nice place, nice weather. It should be a nice time.
Oh, check this out. Tim, can you go by that sign and be like, oh yeah?
Point at it.
Oh yeah. Oh. Oh, party. Oh, what's up? What's up? Look at this dog. Oh, shh. Get out, Kyle. You're gonna die.
Bro, that's he's such a good looking dog.
I like him.
Ferocious.
Hola, chico. Chico es muy guapo. Chico es un bueno chico. Hola, chico. 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 Chico.
See, I've already got my
Chico, Vea.
He knows.
Vea.
He's looking at me because he sees me.
Vea.
He knows I'm from the vault.
Vea. Chico, Vea.
So right now, Max and I are shopping for breakfast for everyone, so what are we gonna get? Okay, so we got frutas y verduras. Kyle. We're gonna get some sucaritas. See,
we got our fruit, we got our dairy products, we got the bread, Nutella.
Okay, we're having our first meal here. We're on our way. I think it's tacos, and I'm excited to have some Mexican cuisine.
I'm gonna get dos tacos, sin guacamole, and I'm pretty excited. Authentic Mexican food.
Dinner at La Gloria would mark the first time we immersed ourselves into the Mexican culture. We ordered in Spanish, and then had some authentic food that the locals usually eat.
This is the best quesadilla I have ever had. I don't remember what type of meat it is, but it is so good.
Mark, how was that?
So good.
Okay, cool. Brandon, Randy?
Hell good.
Nice. Gary?
Some quality tacos.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, it was a pretty successful first day.
Okay, so it is 7:18 a.m., day two, breakfast one. Right now on the skillets, we have scrambled eggs and chorizo sausage. We had to abandon the potato idea because we don't have enough time. But, you know,
we'll get back to it.
Yeah, we can do that
later.
We'll
prep in the night and then cook it.
Exactly.
After breakfast, we met with Eduardo, one of the leaders of the Esperanza organization. We learned about his life, the culture of Tijuana, immigration policies, and more. We then introduced ourselves in Spanish and told him about our lives.
Okay,
I'm bringing my phone next time if we can
talk. Okay. All right. You guys ready? Oh, yeah. Woo! Si te quedas o te vas, si no, no me busques más. Si te vas, yo también me voy. Hasta que duelan los pies. Si te vas, yo también me voy. Si me das.
the build site right now. We're about to get introduced to everyone, including the family we're building the house for.
The family we met was extremely nice, and their hospitality was just incredible. They had so little compared to what we had back at home, yet they were so generous and loving. It was truly a humbling experience.
Hey Anton, what are we doing?
We're building a house.
A lot of hard work, but we're almost finished now. We're gonna grab lunch, some authentic Mexican food.
What we got there, Tim?
Beans and rice and horchata. It's good.
Trying to grab this rebar out of here, but we got all the good ones out first.
We're fantastic chefs. Probably the best here, debatably. Mama.
After a relatively short work day, we hopped on the bus to the border. It was a very surreal moment, imagining the struggles of millions of immigrants because of the border.
So we're here at the border, more namely we're at Friendship Park right now, which approximately once a year, parents and families who are on the United States side of the border fence can come, enter this small park here through the fence, and you can converse and even if you're lucky, touch fingertips with your loved ones who may have been displaced back to across the Mexican border.
Just looking at that wall, you could feel the pain, the sorrow, the isolation. The different perspective was such an eye-opening experience.
Which one's yours?
We're tying at the intersections of all these rebars.
No.
To make sure they don't come loose. And we're tightening them. This is for the roof.
With the roof all tied up, we headed over to La Casa de Inmigrantes. The place is basically like a temporary home or safe haven for deportees and other immigrants who have been pushed away by the US's strict immigration policies. We learned more about their stories and even talked to some of the deportees to hear about their personal lives.
Right now it's 7:40 p.m. and we are walking over to get some ice cream. Yay! Kyle, how's this ice cream?
It's delicious. Very creamy and icy.
We're here at the work site. It's a different house from the past 3 days, but we're digging a hole in which to put foundations for another Esperanza house.
So we worked a lot harder than Randy and Fred's. They had a jackhammer and we just used straight.
Not only do they have the jackhammer, which makes the whole process much easier, we've got more distance than they have.
And more depth.
Using our trusty pickaxe, you know, we're just coming in just boom, and I'm pushing it out.
Yeah, like seven dwarves.
Yeah, pretty much we're all seven dwarves between the two of us, yeah.
Gary, what's going on here?
We're getting some jorts made right now.
Bueno. Oh.
See that?
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. I was like, good gracious, ass, audacious, flirtatious, trying to show patience. I'm waiting for the right time to shoot my steed. You know, waiting for the right time to flash them keys. And I'm leaving, please believe in me and the rest of my heathens. Checking out a lock at the top of the Four Seasons. Penthouse, rooftop, birds, I'm so right now we are going to the orphanage and we're going to learn more about their lives, and I also brought a guitar because we're going to sing Don't Stop Believing to them, so I hope it's going to be good.
We're playing at the orphanage.
Hola!
When something's hidden you can't see them. You like laughing when you start.
Uh-oh.
Pretty good at this game.
How you don't know what. Well, I don't have many and I don't have many. In fact, I don't have any, but I call you. Cause I know those eyes and I know that.
I'm stepping
on the left. Oh, God, and my heart's on fire. Oh, God, and my heart's on fire. Oh, God, and my heart's on fire.
All right, so today we're back at the beginning place that we started on Monday, and now we're just we're making concrete and filling in the first floor here. It's a lot of hard work with the sand and the gravel, and then the concrete and more water, kind of just shoveling it into buckets and then lifting the buckets into the mixer, taking the mixed contents, putting them in wheelbarrows, wheelbarrowing them into the first floor and dumping them. The locals are smoothing it out, but we're doing the lifting, and it's really fun, but really hard work as well.
So it's how it smells.
Some good looking eats, man. Mm.
How about that, Brandon?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. 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 So best so far. Yeah, really good.
All in all, the experience, you know, immersing ourselves in the Tijuanan culture has just been phenomenal. It's been an amazing experience.
As our last workday came to an end, the families and volunteers we helped gave their thanks and were so grateful. It was a pleasure working for them and a great opportunity to create a lovely community.
We're kind of like at the beach. There's a lot of shops here. It's pretty cool. Bunch of knickknacks.
I'm over here. It's got two hammocks. One for Harrison Moore, one for myself. Got them for pretty cheap. You know, no big deal. Pretty good bargainer. 25 for this. You said 27. I'll do 25.
$25.
$50. That's $50. We'll do 25 for both these. And that's how you do it. Pretty easy.
And strut your stuff. Oh. Oh.
You know, it's a nice, beautiful day down here in Tijuana. We're about to head out, so we're all just finishing up our packing. Just got a little shopping done. I just picked up this hammock, bringing it back to the U.S. You know, y'all had a great trip. It's time to head home.
So our trip in Tijuana is coming to an end, but we have to wait in this really, really long line until we get back into the United States. So it's going to take maybe 2 hours, but we have a lot of time on our hands.
This trip went real well.
The Jesuit immersion trip to Tijuana was an amazing adventure and truly a life-changing and eye-opening experience. Along with having a ton of fun, we learned about the life of service and the joy of helping others. You don't need to do much, but if you do small actions with great love, you can change the world one step at a time. We gained a better worldview and also realized that despite many cultural differences, humans are still united by love and kinship. We learned about the beauty of community and how wonderful life is when we are all bounded together by God's love and friendship. The Tijuana immersion trip was a once-in-a-lifetime experience and a remarkable opportunity to show the world what it means to be a man for others.